folks. I'm in Wabash County, Indiana today. This is where I grew up. Right now we're at the spillway, the Salamonie Reservoir. I'd show you the reservoir, but it's at its winter level currently, so not much to see on that side. While that side over there is the reservoir, the backside here is Salamonie River State Forest. And that's where we're going to go today.
Seeing some bald eagles flying right over the river here just outside the spillway. Let's see if I can get them on camera. Here in Salamonie River State Forest, they've only got one campground. They've got one primitive campground and one horseman's campground. And years ago, when I was just a kid, they had several more primitive campgrounds here, but thanks to state funding being reduced constantly, they're down to just this one left now, plus the horseman's. But this area was created by the CCC long ago. The Civilian Conservation Corps built this up. The Stairway to Nowhere. Now, of course, it used to go somewhere. CCC built this probably 90 years ago. And at one time, this was part of the CCC camp. Now it just leads into the back of the primitive campground. Listen to those spring peepers. It's the beginning of March and they're ready for spring. You're probably all thinking, well, hey, Cliff Dweller, why are you out here in this state forest on such a dreary day? We had thunderstorms come through last night. Well, part of it, of course, is nostalgia. This is the first place I ever truly camped. First real adventuring and hiking. Although back then, we didn't even think of it as hiking. We were just out having fun. But secondary purpose is because of the storms that came through last night. There's some waterfalls here, and this should be a perfect time to check them out. Now, of course, when we were growing up, we didn't have trail maps. Most of these are horse trails. There's only one that's actually designated for hiking only. Everything else is mixed hiking and horse trails, which can definitely make the trails pretty messy, but the stars you see on this map, those designate waterfalls. 3F right there is for the Three Waterfalls Trail. We're going to start on that today, and we're going to hunt down these other waterfalls as well. So let's get on it. A lot of these trails here at Salamonie River State Forest are old fire roads. Which those aren't too bad because the horses can't tear them up as much, but this area through here is what remains of one of the old primitive campgrounds that they end up closing down.
It's not a long trail at all from the trailhead to get to the main three waterfalls on this little hike, assuming you stay on the original trail. Thank you. creek.
You see there is the path I came down underneath all that rock. That's falls one. That's supposed to be falls two. So now we're going to go find falls number three.
This is typically a very beautiful forest in the spring and summer. But as you can probably tell, the falls can dry up pretty quickly in the summer.
So, according to the trail map, that pretty much ends this particular trail, but it ain't gonna stop us. Like I said, there's all kinds of trails through this place, been blazed over many years, not to mention all the horse trails, or just follow a stream. Let's do it. I'm up on the bluff above the Salamonie River. You can literally look down here in the leaves and just see the trails that crisscross. This is a ravine hiked several years ago. See the drop off for that one there, but it's not very tall. I'm not sure if we can make our way down there to see it from below or not. It's pretty washed out. That is an amazing view of that river. Now at the bottom of this washed out trail, it's another little tributary stream. It looks like it might have some waterfalls on it.
Thank you. such down here, Salamonie River State Forest. I don't remember coming down in this way before.
Since I've never, to my knowledge that I can recollect, been down in this creek, I'm just gonna follow it a little bit and see what we see. Some nice signs of spring down here. Some flowers. That's a pretty old can right there. Or not.
We'll come back up out of the creek. Definitely a beautiful place, especially when you get into a section that you don't really remember. Maybe I've never been in this spot. I like it. Frankly, I kind of lost my spot on the map. There's so many trails here shooting off in all these different directions. So I just headed out on the biggest one that I ran across. And in literally no time at all, bring me right back out, straight across from the primitive campground. I mean, this is literally the trail that we used to take so many times. But I ain't done yet. Need to head in the other direction. Still got at least one more waterfall to see.
So down here at the end of the, well, this end of the state forest area, is a spot called Hominy Ridge. And this is Hominy Ridge Lake. One of the first places I ever fished at. And it was built by the CCC back in the day as well.
Now that, straight there, the boat ramp is where I was at the beginning of this video when I videotaped the eagles. Interesting enough, the woods behind that area is the Kokilani Nature Preserve, managed by Acres Land Trust. I will post a link at the end of this video to one of our hikes over in Kokilani. They have a really nice waterfall as well. In fact, it's straight into those woods, straight back there. If you didn't have the trees, you could see it. There goes an eagle now. Missed him. It's a beautiful little creek.
pretty good place out here to adventure in. Whether you're into hiking, camping, or fishing, good spot for it. For people who like the CCC history, things that they built and how long they last, here at the Hominy Ridge picnic area, you can see their handiwork. Picnic tables, all stone construction. There's quite a few of those out here. And this old fireplace. And you can see it's been redone a couple of times, but the original was CCC. And this pavilion up here, the stonework was all theirs.
These massive fireplaces are just amazing. Fellow YouTube friends out there, who else records like 5 times as much video as what they actually need? Because I know it's going to take me like a week to sift through the video just from this one short adventure to make this video. Come on, I'm not alone here, right? Surely you guys probably, maybe, no?